this video, we will learn about split range control. To understand the common terms used for process controller like process variable PV, set point SP and output OP, you can watch the previous video available in this channel. Let us first understand the difference between a split range control and normal closed loop control. This diagram demonstrates a normal closed loop control without split range control. The output of the controller will send the same output to both the control valve and pump. Since the level in the tank is below the controller's set point, the output is zero. Let us evaluate the behavior of the process when we introduce flow into the inlet of the tank. When the level starts to increase, the level transmitter LT will sense the increase of the level. Since the tank level has yet to exceed the controller set point, the output including the valve opening and pump speed are maintained at 0%. Due to the valve still fully closed, the tank level will continue to increase. Once the tank level increases above the set point, both the control valve opening and pump speed will increase. This will cause the tank level to slowly return back to the controller's set point. One important observation in this example is that the control valve will be at partially open even after the process already stabilized. When the control valve is partially opened, it will create unnecessary back pressure to the pump. Another disadvantage is that the control valve is subjected to more wear and tear as it is continuously throttling whenever there is process disturbance. The smaller opening of the control valve will also subject the seat and plug of the control valve to more erosion, thus shorten the lifespan of the control valve. We will now evaluate how split range control will overcome these issues. This diagram shows a setup with split range control. The difference here is the output of the controller now sends different signal to the control valve and the pump. The control valve will receive 0 to 50% signal range, while the pump will receive 50 to 100% signal range. To understand how split range control works, let us assume the controller output increases to 50%. At controller output value of 50%, the valve opening now is at 100%. However, the pump speed will remain at 0%. The reason the pump speed is not increased is because the split range control will only increase the pump speed when the controller output controller is above 50%. At this point of time, the controller output is still not above 50%. When the controller output is above 50%, we can observe the pump speed slowly increases to 100%. Next, we will evaluate how the actual behavior of the split range control when the tank level increases. When the level in the tank increases, the level transmitter's reading will increase. Since the tank level is yet to exceed the controller's set point, the controller's output will remain at 0%. Thus, the valve opening and pump speed also at 0%. When the tank level increases above the controller's set point, the controller's output will increase. At this point of time, the valve opening will slowly increase to 100%. However, since the controller's output yet to exceed 50%, the pump speed will stay at 0%. As the pump yet to start, the tank level will not reduce back to the controller's set point. This will cause the controller's output to further increase. Once the controller's output value is above 50%, the pump speed will increase. In this example, we observe that the control valve opening is always at 100%. With the control valve fully open, there is less back pressure to the pump. The control valve will also be subjected to lesser wear and tear as it always stays at 100% and not throttling. We are at the end of this video. Thanks for watching this video. Please feel free to subscribe to this channel and watch the other videos.